Hello everybody, and welcome to this lecture on computer architecture. Now I would like to talk to you about Carnot maps, because Carnot maps are a very nice and easy way to reduce the complexity of our circuits by reducing the complexity of the associated Boolean expression that we are trying to implement. So how does this exactly work? Let's take a look. Let me first do a small summary of what we did in the last lecture. That was about the sum of products and the products of sums. This was a way of implementing any logic function that we can come up with by analyzing the truth table of the function and then taking the min term for every one that is in the truth table and then ORing all these min terms into the sum of products. So in this case, for instance, the truth table has a line, has a 1 in line 0, in line 2, and in line 3. So we just sum, that is to say, we OR the products, that is to say, the ends that are in these associated min terms. So at the end, we get the function is m0 plus m2 plus m3 in this case. That is, it is not A and not B and not C, or not A or B or not C, or not A and B and C. That is what we call the sum of products. In the same way, we could also do max terms, and the max terms is a OR, that is a sum or an ORing operation of the three variables by a combination such that it will give, for that line, it will give a zero. And then in the products of sums, we copy, that is to say, we end all the max terms that have a zero in the truth table. So in this case, it would be max term m1, m4, m5, m6, and m7. And that is to say, we get this expression as written here at the bottom. And I already presented to you, I already promised you in the last lecture that actually this can still be simplified. So just look at this expression and you can see that this can be simplified. If you don't know how this works, let me again show how this is done. And I put this one on the side here, because for the moment we don't need this. But what I do need, I need this table, because we're going to go back to the original logic with the important observations. So if we look at this, I've written it down already, prepared it. So this was actually the functions that we are trying to implement. This is the function f with the three max terms that are here. But as you can see here, that this can easily be simplified, because I see here, let me put it in red, I see here that these two terms, this one and this one, they have A and not C, and this one A and not C in common. So what can I do? I write this in another way. I write this not A, not C, and then and B, not B or B. And then I still have this third term, which I leave unaffected. But now we have the format, the same expression is written like this. And as you know, not B or B, as from our table here, not A or not A, or in our case, a B and not B equals 1. So B and not B, this one equals 1. And ending with 1, it actually is just then the thing that is being ended. So this one is not A or and not C. And we still have this term here, not A and B and C. So we already have the equation is already simpler. But it can actually be simplified even more, as we will see, as I show you now, because I can always add one of these terms in my function, because it's like this. If we have A or A equals A, so any term that I have, I can just OR with itself. So what I will do here, I like this term here. So this one, I will just add here. I will, that is to say, OR here at the end of the expression. That is not A, B, not C. So I also have to put it here, not A, B, and not C. And also here, not A, B, and not C. I still have the same expression. And now I see here that this one, let me put it also in another color, this one has not A, B with this one in common. So I can also put this in brackets. That means I still have here not A, oh, I want to have black, black, not A, not C, or not A, B, C, or not C. Sometimes I will not write these dots in between, but if there are two variables joined, you should imagine there is an AND operation in between. So all these things here, they have dots in between, also here. If not, they have here like an OR. So once again, C or not C, that equals actually 1. So what we have here is not A, not C, or not A, B. And this is the form that we have now. We can get also with a Carnot map, which goes a little bit easier. But before I do this, I will make one more step that to show you that even with Carnot maps, we will not get always to the easiest solution. Because as you can see here now, this one has one AND gate, one OR gate, and one AND gate, so that is 3 gates. But I can still, even with this, we can arrive with this with Carnot map. I will show you in a moment. Carnot. But we can still simplify it more, because this would be not A, and I can put it in parentheses, as you notice, it's not C or B. And this would be the simplest expression you can imagine. So this is one AND gate and an OR gate, which is quite nice. It would be something like, let me put here ABC, ABC. So it would be here we have a NOT. But first we have to do not A or B. Let me put it like this. And then we end it with not A. And we put it here in an AND gate. So this would be the expression F with 2 gates. Now, how do you do this? How could we come up with this expression here using Carnot maps? Let me show you how this works. So I go back to this original situation, and now what am I going to do? I'm going to write the truth table in a way that I will make it into a square table here, like this, and I will divide for every variable that I have, I will divide it in 2. So I will write here A and here not A. And I can do this in various ways. It doesn't matter so much. There are people that do it in one way or the other. Just find out which way you like it most. The organization of the variables here. I just do it like this because it's easiest to explain. It's not the fastest way, but it's easiest to explain. So I put here A not A, B not B. And here at the bottom I will put C, the variable C. So I have to divide every field into 2. And it's a little bit different than if you already used the top, then here you have to do C, not C, and here not C. The thing of this table, now that I have it here, is that 2 neighboring cells here, they differ by 1 variable and by 1 variable only. And this is very important, as we will see in a moment. But what am I going to do now? I will place all these 1s and 0s the same. I will put here into my Carnot map. This is the Carnot map. So let's see, this the important one is this one that I have here. Where am I going to put this? This will be with the min term not A, not B, not C. Well, not A, that is this. So these are these 4. Then not B are these 2 here. And then not C, it's this one. So here we have a 1. And this 0, where does it go? This goes at not A, not B, and C. Not A, not B, and C. This must be this 0, but I want it black now. I want black. So here's a 0. Where is this 1? I want this one. I decided I wanted this one blue. Where does this 1 go? That is not A, B, not C. Not A, B, these are these 2, not C. That is this one. So here we have a 1. Where does this 1 go to? It's not A, B, C, that is the min term that is associated to it, not A, B, C. So I want this one, let me put this in green, not A, B, C, not A, B, C, that is this one. And as you can see, the rest of the fields are all 0, so let me put them black and let me put them 0. These are all 0. And now the thing is, like we had in the previous expression, that if we have in the expression 2 terms that differ only by 1 variable, in this case here it was that the variable C was different. That means that if they differ in only one variable, it means they must be neighbors in this Carnot map. So this, I have to say this, this is a Carnot, I think you have to pronounce it like this, Carnot map. And the thing is that if you have two terms in your expression that differ by only one variable, it means that they are neighbors here in the Carnot map. And the other way around, if they differ by only one variable, then they have the complement to one of the variables. So for in this case it was, remember, here we have B and here we have not B, and that permitted us to eliminate the variable B from our expression. So in this case I will also do this. Let's see if I can put this maybe purple. So these two neighbors, these two terms, they differ by B and not B. And where are these two? This was it was this one, that is this, and this one is this. And you can see, indeed, they are neighbors. And when they are neighbors, I can eliminate one of the variables. So which variable is it? Well, I already know it is the variable B, because I can see here, these two elements, they have B and not B. So that means that I can eliminate B. What remains then is not A and not C. So this here is not A and not C. That's interesting. So now we have still, and what we have to do, we have to sum to this, or ORing to this, the other ones at least once. So what we could do, actually, we would probably do something like this. We see here an isolated one, and that one we still have to attribute this, and that is not A, B, C, which is actually the same as this term. So this would be our final, at first thought we might think that this would be our final function, f equals, but as you can see, this can actually be, remember from the previous one, it could actually be simpler. We just had three gates, while here we would have 1, 2, 3, 4 gates. So we can actually simplify this. How do we do this? Well, we'll undo this, what I have here. Because actually we can, this one, we can join with this one. So let me put this in this color. These two can also be joined. And these are these two members of the expression here. So we can also join this. And what are these? These are one variable is eliminated. If you have a pair, one variable is eliminated. Which variable in this case is eliminated? Well, you can see you have here C and not C. So C is eliminated. What do we have here left? It's not A and B. So this is our, then our final, after the Carnot map, we have the expression F equals not A and not C, or not A and B. And we have the three gates, we have the three operations. And we have seen, we have attributed all the ones in our Carnot map, so we have also attributed something to all ones in the truth table. So this is how we do this with the sum of products. The same we can actually do with the product of sums. Let me see if I have this. I already have it prepared. That is this one. But now we have to do something different. Let me first show you. We have to again draw the Carnot map. So, but there's a difference between this, sum of products 2, I have it here. There's a difference between this. I wanted to show to you that when in the product of sums, where in the sum of products you have here the negatives, not A, not B, not C, you would have in the product of sums, you have here A or B or C. So this is not negated. So what do we have to do here? We have to do the opposite. labeling, because that will save us work. We can also actually do this in the same way. It doesn't matter. We can don't have to negate this. But this way it goes faster, because we already have the Carnot map, which we then can just copy. Let me see here. So here we have to put not C, C, C. To compare, look at this. You have here A, not A, B, not B, etc. While here we have not A, A, not B, B. So we have inverted them. But then in this way, the table, I don't have to do any thinking. I can just do like this. One, one. I can just copy the Carnot map. And now instead of hunting for ones, I have to hunt for zeros. And I can see here, well, this is nice. There are four of them here. And if there are four of them, it means I can eliminate actually two variables. And if there would be eight, I could eliminate three variables, meaning all variables. That is to say, if there's two variables, if there's two zeros joined, then I can eliminate one variable. If there's four, I can eliminate two, and so on. So these four zeros, I can now actually, because now we're hunting for zeros, I can actually eliminate two variables. Which variables would it be? I see here that we have B and not B, so this one can be eliminated. And I see we have here C and not C, so C can be eliminated. So this one is just, what remains is not A. And now we still have to attribute this zero. Once again, we could just put it like this and find the expression, which would be, let me see, that would be A or, I see here, A or B or not C, B or not C. So that is A or B or not C. That would be this one that was still remaining. The other ones are the red ones. But actually, I'm going to do the same trick. I'm not going to join only use the individual zero. No, I will join as many maximum number of zeros possible. I see actually only these two. I don't see how I can do four. It cannot be that, for instance, that you might think that I could do these four. No, because they are not neighbors. It's not like this. This you cannot do. You have to do then four that are actually packed together. And I cannot find this, so the only thing I have is these two zeros, and this would be, let me see, what do we have here? They are, what is the variable that's eliminated? Well, I see here it has A and not A, so A can be eliminated. So this would be B or not C. So the final product of sums then would be the product of this one and this one, and that is not A. Oh, I wanted black. Not A and B or not C. And to compare this to what we have found before, we see here by the sum of products, we also got not A and not C or B. And we have here also now in this product of sums, we reach the same conclusion, not A and B or not C. So this is the way to go ahead. How does this work? Carnot maps. In Carnot maps, what we're doing, we are writing the exact truth table in a way in a Carnot map. And then for the sum of products, we are hunting for ones to join ones so that we can eliminate variables from our expression. While in the product of sums, we are hunting from zeros so that we can eliminate variables in our product of sums. And at the end, it will lead to a simpler circuit or simpler logic. But remember, not always does it lead to the simplest expression possible. It leads to a simpler expression, but not necessarily to the simplest. But anyway, we will save gates, we will save logic operations, therefore gates, therefore transistors. And that is the entire idea of this Carnot maps, is to save transistors at the end. I hope you enjoyed this lecture.